Welcome back, Fish Hunt Northwest. Back here in studio, Dwayne England, Kelly Barnum, of course. Well, I'll just say the Chuckleheads. It's easier than running through the names. Anyway, hey Barnum, I was at work yesterday morning, and we started texting back and forth. There was a tragic event that transpired out there at the washaway on the ocean with an 18-foot fiberglass boat.
Right.
Folks that you actually know.
Right. Well, it's a small community.
Down there, and they venture out to do some salmon fishing. Salmon fishing's been good, and we advocate getting out there, but. Again, as we mentioned before the break, you do a great job week in and week out educating folks on the importance of checking not just your weather forecast, but your ocean forecast as well,
right,
for good reason. And yesterday, if you were sitting home with your Duckworth and was going to go fish the ocean and was thinking about that Willapa area, you would have stayed home.
Right. So I got a call yesterday from a buddy right about 10 o'clock. I think the mayday for a vessel overturned, I think, happened right around 9:15.
Mm-hmm.
So I got a call from my buddy, and he said, "Hey, there's a vessel capsized at Washaway. Are you fishing today?" And I said, "No, thank God."
Yeah.
And so the first thing I did when I saw it was I went to the ocean report. Went to the ocean report, saw swells were, I think, yesterday, if I remember right, 7 to 9 feet at like 9 seconds. Wind waves were 1 to 3 feet with 10 to 20 knot winds. And as soon as I looked at that, I went, "Ooh, that's ugly to be out at Washaway." Well, then next thing I did was I pulled up the tides and looked at the tides. We had about an 8 o'clock high flood, which means you're going to have about a 9 o'clock max ebb.
Mm-hmm.
And it was, as soon as I saw that, I went, yeah.
That's a no-go.
Right. So what I want to do here is hop up and just kind of go back through some of this information again. Before I even focus on Willapa and talk about Willapa, I just want to go to this. This is, you go on Google, you type in NOAA Marine Forecast, N-O-A-A Marine Forecast. You type that in and it's going to bring you to a generic page and it's going to give you a map. You go over to that map and you click that map anywhere you want to go fishing. Right here, let's click the mouth of the Willapa. Right there, we click it, give it a second. And it's gonna pop up a forecast. Right here, it's gonna give me everything I need to know about upcoming weather. Again, they're going to update this every single 6 hours. Most of the time, it's like 3 a.m., 9 a.m., so on and so on. You look at it, so we look at Friday. Variable winds less than 5 knots, becoming northwest 6 to 11 knots. Mixed swell, west-southwest, 2 to 3 feet at 14 seconds. I mean, this is all the information you need right here on what the ocean, what the swell, what the wind waves are gonna do. We talked about this earlier in an episode with Ian from All River Charters. Take your swell, add your wind waves to the top of that, and that is your combined seas. That is what you can expect it to be. 2 feet at 13 seconds with a 2 to 3 foot wind waves means 4 to 5 foot combined seas. Okay, so that covers that. This takes you on today's cellular devices. I save it as a bookmark, and I just pull it up as a bookmark and look at it, but this takes you literally less than 30 seconds, okay? Then you wanna pop over if you wanna get a bar report. So if you're fishing Willapa Westport, most of the time you gotta cross the bar, or at least you're fishing just inside the bar this time of year on Willapa. This is weather underground. Again, you're not gonna get a Willapa bar report because the Coast Guard doesn't have a station on Willapa, so you're not gonna get that updated bar report. But I can go to a Westport bar report, and then right here I can get a Columbia River bar report, and I can look at these bars, and I can audit, I can take these and go, okay, well this is gonna give me a really good idea of what the Willapa bar is doing. So here it is for today, as of 2:44 p.m., combined seas 2 to 4 feet, bar conditions light, max ebb currents will occur around 1:30 a.m. Okay, so I'm just going to make the current stuff really simple. This is what happened yesterday on the Willapa Bay. High tide yesterday, like I said, was right around 8 o'clock. You're going to get a max, you're going to have a max, a flood high water at 8 o'clock.
Right.
So now you have a complete estuary completely full of water to the hilts. Okay. 1 hour after that tide changes and starts to go out, you're going to have what they call max ebb. that is when the current for about 45 minutes to the hour is going to be as strong as it gets.
Right.
You have the maximum flush of water leaving the estuary.
A full bathtub and you just pull the drain, right?
Yep.
That's exactly what it is.
And so what happened yesterday was during that high flood, before the max ebb, things were a little choppy. Yeah. Things were a little ugly out there. Let's pop over here to Google Earth. And this is Willapa Bay right here. The thing to understand about Willapa Bay has 260 square miles of surface area. It is the second largest estuary in the United States as far as surface area.
Wow. That's huge.
I mean, it is a giant, giant estuary.
Mm-hmm.
And we focus in on this little area right here. The mouth of Willapa Bay, what many people refer to as Washaway. If you look right here, this is the highway when you're headed down to Westport from Tokeland.
Yeah.
This is the highway right here. This is the beach. This is what is referred to as Washaway.
Mm-hmm.
This is the area of land that over the last 50 years, the bay has eaten and completely removed miles of land right here. So you're taking 260 square miles of water and you're pushing it through a channel here that might be a half a mile wide at the most. Where the Columbia River bar is probably somewhere 3 to 4 miles wide. Westport's probably a couple miles wide. So you're taking an estuary that's the second largest in the country and you're flushing it through a half a mile. This area right here, this is the little jetty that sticks out along the highway. A lot of people make the mistake of assuming that because they see a jetty, that this is the bar. Once I get across that jetty, I'm free sailing because I'm in the ocean and it's gonna be calmer in the ocean. That is not correct. This jetty right here along the highway was not put in to break waves for fishermen leaving the harbor. It was not put in for, you know, making less swell conditions for boats passing through. It was put in for one reason only, to save this highway right here, because all of this was going away. It was getting eaten. This jetty is probably minus getting out here when you get into the A buoys and the B buoys and the C buoys. The area around this jetty right here is extremely dangerous on a max ebb. I mean, extremely dangerous. When I pull up this chart right here, and you'll have to bear with me a little bit because it kind of goes blurry before it locks in. This is that jetty right here. So let's picture right here. This submerged dike right here is what they're calling it on here. But let's picture something here that's about less than a half a mile wide right here, maybe a quarter mile wide. 5 to 7 knots of current going from 94 to 80 feet deep to 30 feet deep,
mm-hmm.
and then back down to 70 to 80 feet deep.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, I've crossed this jetty. I think, Tony, you've probably crossed this jetty. The confused water that happens around that jetty, I mean, I've seen whirlpools at that jetty that I'm like, oh my God, it's going to suck my boat down.
Yeah.
And it probably could.
Probably.
Yeah. I mean, there is some amazing currents that happen right there. So it's really important as you're leaving this area, and there's very few people that I think that cross the bar at Willapa, and mm-hmm. I don't cross the bar at Willapa very often at all, maybe just once or twice a year because of the fact that, so as I zoom out on this chart, this is the sea buoy here. This is kind of your last indicator of you're getting headed out to the bar. If you look at this bar right here, this white area here, you're seeing, this is kind of just before the bar, and you're seeing 35, 43, 30, 28, 21. This is where things get crazy dangerous on the Willapa. Right as you're starting to break out and bust out into the ocean and into those ocean currents, look at these depths right here at low water, 14, 16, 15, 13. I mean, every time I cross Willapa Bar, I'm looking at my depth finder and going, oh my God.
Yeah.
Oh my God. Oh my God. And then you'll get out here and pop into 26 and go,
Oh, thank goodness.
We made it. But I mean, you feel like you're going to run aground.
Yeah.
And I mean, it says it right here on the chart, breakers.
Right.
And as I go back to Google Earth and I come out to this area,
look what
breakers.
You see.
Yeah. Breakers. Wow. You know, and then I go back a little bit more, breakers. It's very important when you guys are fishing Willapa. I mean, I want all of you guys to come down to Willapa and fish. It is an absolutely amazing fishery. All of you. It's very important that if you're going to fish the Washaway area, you know, west of Tokeland, that number one, check your weather conditions, check your tide conditions, and make sure your equipment, your motors are spot on. Carry an anchor. I know this sounds crazy, but carry an anchor in the front of your boat and have it ready. Mm-hmm. If you get out in the washaway area from, say, when you guys go down there, you'll see the jetty, you'll see the house that sits out on the rock pile. If you start to get west of that house and you have motor troubles, your only hope and savior, if you're broke down, is to throw an anchor. You have to, because if you get sucked into any one of those sets, I mean, these breakers, they are Hawaii 5-0.
Yeah.
They are 15 to 20 foot rollers. Yeah. I mean, crazy. You've seen them. They will kill you like that.
Yeah.
I mean, Mother Nature is a bitch.
Do not
want to
go there.
She does not care.
That's right.
She does not care. So well, make sure your equipment is dialed in and you do your homework and know what conditions you're facing.
And that's the takeaway here. And I think that's what we kind of expressed at the beginning of this before Barnum, you know, dove deep into it. And if you miss something, the beauty of it is you can go back and watch this. Matter of fact, I will cut this out of the entire show and put it as a standalone because it's good information, not just for Willapa and the washaway area, but for any ocean area that you intend to go fish. It's just a process. Get in your routine. Check your weather. Check your ocean forecast. Understand exactly where you're going to go. Check your Google Earth. Look at your maps. Look at your charts and whatnot to understand the depths of water that you're going to navigate. Those are set up at low water conditions, so you get familiar with what you can be. You can anticipate at extreme low tides and whatnot.
So yesterday was a perfect example. If you would have known your tides, you're out there at 8 o'clock, 8:15. Things are starting to get a little saucy.
Yep.
Another buddy of mine was out there, and at about 8:15, 8:30, he decided in his 22-foot Hughes craft that he didn't like it. And he left.
Time to go.
If you knew the tides yesterday, you would have known at 8:15 that the tide's flipping, it's starting to go out. Max ebb is about to happen, and it's nautical right now.
Yeah.
It's going to get
time
really
to
bad.
Yeah.
And they didn't know the tides, and unfortunately, tragedy happened.
Sorry, obviously, for the tragedy that did occur. Yeah. Prayers to the family and the loss that transpired from yesterday. And, you know, we just want you to be safe out there. Mm-hmm. So, take this information to heart, utilize it the best you can, and wear your life vest above all, okay? Put your life vest on, don't take chances, know your weather, know your conditions.
And know your boat.
And know your boat.
Know your boat, know whether or not your boat can handle the conditions you're fishing in. No fish is worth your life.